Johnny Nelson, thanks for joining us on Inside Athletic Performance. First of all, just give us a bit of an insight on what we can expect tomorrow night.
I think tomorrow night Manchester's bringing a new season back into boxing. Anthony Joshua, of course, everybody, all eyes are on him, as well as Scott Quigg, to see how Scott Quigg, not just win, it's not just about the win, it's how he wins, how he gets the job done. That's most important, because everybody's talking about Carl Frampton at the moment, and now Carl Frampton's a man. You know, he's the best of the bunch. And Scott Quigg's got to be reminded, well, is he really? And that his performance, it's not just about winning for Scott.
You said on Sky Sports News that his mind might not be on the job and he's looking too far in front of the
believer. I did, and he was quick to correct that and say, well, no, my mind is on the job. I find it almost impossible to ignore what happened last weekend with Frampton. Yes, he might not be on the job. I reckon he stops Des Moines in about seven rounds. But again, he's just got to put on a devastating performance. And me saying that, I'm good. I'm good, it's made him pay attention to it, because I think it'll make him more focused to say, right, forget Frampton, this is my job in front of me.
Did you got the question? Oh, what's the question? A word on Anthony Crawler, if you.
Anthony Crawler, he's got a tough one in front of him. Anthony Crawler's always underestimated him, and I've never given him the benefit of the doubt. I think I backed him against Murray, because I thought I know Murray would have beat him, but I knew Murray no. And he seems to rise to the occasion. You step up the level of opponent, and he steps up again. So he'll never really get the credit he deserves until he gets to the point where it's plain and simple written in black and white in your forehead.
I've remembered the question. Do you see Quigg Frampton next year? Do you see it happening?
It's got to. Both these guys says we're not going to fight each other unless we've got a world title. Now they've got a world title. The only reason why this fight won't happen is because of the boxing politics, the jungle of boxing. That's what kills the sport. They have both now got world titles. They don't need to be saying, I'm going to box him first and him first. They both have titles. This fight should happen again. So whoever the managers are, whoever the promoters are, they need to get in a room and get this thrashed out, because there is no excuse.
How big can this fight be?
It can be big. It can be big, and that's what I'm saying, these world titles on the line. You put in Ireland, massive. You put in Manchester, massive. You know, so again, it can be big.
Word on yourself, I read last week they might be making a potential comeback. How's that coming along, is
one
it?
It's one night only. There's no way I'm going to come back to have a career as a boxer. I said, look, I'll come back, you've got 6 months to prepare for this kid, and I'll come back and box him and beat him. And that's it. I don't want a career as a fighter, I'm too old for that. Yeah. But I know I could beat Michael Holmes. It's a great story, he's had 13 defences, he wants to make his 14 defence. Why not make it against the guy who set the record, which is me? Hopefully, he'll be stupid enough to think Johnny Nelson is an old man. Yeah, I'll do him, it's great glory. Oh, I'm glad he thinks like that. I actually like the fact that most of the public think I'll get turned over. I love it. Because to me, I know success and the glory of the win will be, you know, you won't be able to match it against anything, I think. I want you to say, I told you so, I just said, I must have been lucky. And that's how you roll with it.
If it does happen, wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us on Inside Athletic Performance.
That's cool.
And we'll speak to you soon. Thanks, Johnny.